Indeed. And, you know, some of us have been saying for a very long time now, 2-3 years, that the government actually needs to put the resources into the processing side of the asylum claims. Otherwise, exactly this would happen. They didn't listen. Everything that the Home Office has done regarding immigration, regarding the asylum system, regarding the small boats has been one-off, standalone decisions or actions or changes, rather than being part of an overall strategic framework with a set of serious national objectives that all the different agencies can align themselves to and properly resourced. Now, that's what most countries have. We don't. And the other thing about this, and the report highlights this or sort of illustrates this very well, is that you can't simply do something in one area without it, of asylum without it having a knock-on somewhere else. And, you know, if you are not processing correctly, you are going or fast enough, if you haven't put the resources into it, if you haven't trained your staff adequately, which is the case, then you are going to have a problem in terms of accommodation. And so then you end up with additional taxpayer costs there. You know, it is mind-bogglingly incompetent of the Home Office to have put it together like this. There is no plan.
Labour Party would say that clearing the backlog is the answer, but what would you say to the fact that the UK has one of the lowest return rates and refusal rates of asylum in all of mainland Europe? In fact, only 24% of claims are knocked back. So surely clearing the backlog would just mean more people being granted asylum in the UK, which won't solve the problem at all.
Indeed, you're absolutely right, Martin. And that is essentially the plan. There's a simplification of the questions that are going to be asked now. That's the idea already with the government. Labour, I'm sure, would just simply put more resources into asking equally simple and thin questions. They're not probing enough by any means. And the staff asking the questions have no knowledge whatsoever of the areas that these people have either come from or travelled through. So they're totally ill-equipped to make a proper decision. It becomes a paperwork tick-box exercise rather than a proper investigation into the asylum claim. But the other thing, Martin, is you've got sort of three elements. You've got, why are people leaving the place that they are leaving? You've got, why are they moving along the route that they are moving along, and how? And how do we disrupt that? And then you've got the pull factor. Why do they come to the UK? And all of that is really, it's not being dealt with. You mentioned the returns, but to do a return, you've got to connect your immigration and your Home Office with your foreign affairs, with the embassies and so on, with the Foreign and Commonwealth and Development Office. That's not happening. There is no unified structure. There is no national working group trying to work this issue. The Home Office wants something. They have to go to the Foreign Office. The Foreign Office then scrabbles around, talks about it, thinks about it a bit, scratches their head, goes back, asks a few questions. And, you know, it takes a month of Sundays to even sort of get any ball rolling, let alone sort of get an agreement completed. The whole thing needs to go back to the drawing board. And I know that that means that in the meantime, we've got to continue this sort of band-aid type of response. But we need to have a national working group, a borders working group, that brings all these agencies together with sufficient authority, somebody chairing it with sufficient authority to make them actually coordinate, put together a proper plan, national strategic objectives, and ensuring the unity of effort of all the government agencies involved. You know, even Albania has that. Macedonia has it. Tajikistan, some of the poorest countries in the Northern Hemisphere, have done this, and it works. The UK does not. One final example, Martin. You know, we've got, by my calculation, depends how you sort of work it, but 7 or 8 different government departments and agencies with patrol vessels working on our in the English Channel. Now, I know that's slightly different to the asylum processing, but it's an illustration of how badly organised this is. You go to Finland, you go to Sweden, you go to Canada, you go to the United States, you go to Holland, you go to any of these places, and you will find that you have got one agency that responds to all the various things on their borders. You know, so like a police patrol car will respond to a burglary or a drunken disorderly or a road traffic collision. You know, here we don't. We've got Border Force dealing with immigration on the on the on the maritime borders. We've got the Navy and we've got the fisheries protection vessels doing the fisheries protection. We've got other people doing pollution control. They're all a different agency for each thing. It's like having a police car dealing with road traffic collisions, another one to deal with drunken disorderly, another one to deal with burglaries. I mean, it's just mind-bogglingly inefficient.
Okay, it Henry Bolton, we're gonna have to leave it there. I know you could keep talking until Christmas. Thank you, expert analysis as ever. Thank you for joining us on Breakfast.
Thank you very much.